شعیب شیخ محمد رفیق آپ ڈائس پر تشریف لائیے
نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters I welcome all of you with the Islamic greetings السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته myself Shaikh Shoaib Rafiq from Al-Marif English School Grade 4. The topic of my talk is Women's Right in Islam. The issue of women in Islam is the topic of great misunderstanding and distortion. Ignorant people highlighting women as inferior in an Islamic scripture, which is not true. But the truth is the Holy Quran, which stresses fairness and justice. Towards women oftentimes. Women's right, according to the Oxford Dictionary, means the right that promotes a legal and social equality of women with men. I am not too much concerned about the categorical remarks and statements made by scientists that how a woman should lead a life. I am going to base my study, which is based on truth and evidence, from the glorious Quran. If you take the Quran as a whole, many of these differences will be solved, inshallah. If we look upon the social rights of women in Islam, then the Quran already mentioned in chapter number 81, verse number 8 and 9, وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُوِلَتْ بِأَيِّ زَمْبٍ قُتِلَتْ which means, and when the female infant child is buried alive, will be questioned for what crime was she killed. Killing any female infant is prohibited in Islam. Not only female infant, but also killing any infant child is prohibited in Islam. But if we see in our country, this form of evil was practiced late till 1870s. Where the Quran clearly prohibits such act 1400 years ago. Among the legal rights of women in Islam, I would like to quote one verse from the glorious Quran. From Surah Ma'idah, chapter number 5, verse number 38. وَالسَّارِقُ وَالسَّارِقَةُ فَقْتَوْا أَيْدِيَهُمَا جَزَاءً As for the thief, male or female, chop off their hands as a punishment for their deeds. This shows that no criminal, whether male or female, would be left rescued without being punished if it follows the Islamic law. My dear brothers and sisters, I would like to end up my speech with the conclusion that if someone is to judge the religion, he or she should not watch what an individual does or what does the community shows. Instead, one should read the authentic sources, that is the glorious Quran and the Hadith of Prophet. Jazakallahu khair for listening my speech with great patience. Wa akhiru da'wana anilhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وعلیکم السلام ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ فیبلس اسپیچ آپ سن رہے تھے شیخ شعیب محمد رفیق کی زبان سے بہت عمدہ بہت ہی خوب آئیے جانتے ہیں اپنے دوسرے جج شیخ ہاشم سے اس اسپیچ کے بارے میں
ماشاءاللہ بہت اچھا آپ نے تقریر کیا ماشاءاللہ آپ نے اللہ آپ کو جزائے خیر عطا فرمائے اور اللہ آپ کو ترقیوں سے نوازے اور ہو سکتا ہے انشاءاللہ کہ آپ ہمارے اس ڈے کے ونر بھی ہو سکتے ہیں آپ انتظار کریں انشاءاللہ آپ کو جلد رزلٹ ملے گا انشاءاللہ اور اللہ آپ کو مزید ترقیوں سے نوازے
ایسے ہی اور ویڈیوز بنانے میں ہماری مدد کریں